When working with Adobe Illustrator, it's important to know that the fonts that you have on your particular machine may not be available on someone else's machine. So let's say you're going to create an Illustrator file and you're going to send it off to a printer or to a client or maybe even to a teacher for a class you're taking, and you have two different fonts in use. You have Times New Roman, and then you have a font, let's say, that you downloaded. This is called Things We Said from defont.com. You have these two types in your project, but the person who opens your file, if they don't have Things We Said, and it's pretty unlikely that they will, then they're not going to be able to see what this should have looked like. Now, they will see this because Times New Roman is something that's common on all machines, so they will be able to see this, but it severely limits the amount of choices you have in terms of type if you just stick with those fonts that are available on all machines. So there has to be a way that you can use custom type, but actually have it show to other people who don't have that type on their machine. Well, there is. The first thing we need to do is see what happens when somebody opens a document that you have created and they don't have the font for. So I'll go ahead and open up this file that I created on a PC. And on the PC, I created font in the same exact Onyx Italic or Anki or whatever this font is called. And it's not showing up here, and it's saying that it's trying to replace the font. Now, this font may or may not be available on Adobe Typekit, and if you're working with Creative Cloud or Creative Cloud 2014, it's going to try to find the alternative in Adobe Typekit. If you're working with earlier versions of Illustrator, it'll tell you it just doesn't have this font and that you need to find an alternate. So whichever version you're working with and whatever you choose to do with it, basically it's saying that it doesn't have it, so you're going to have to find something else, or you're going to have to go find that font and download it. So I'll go ahead and hit close, and as you can see, this font turned out just fine because it was made with Arial, and Arial is common on all machines. Again, this font isn't fine because it's been converted to something else. You can see up here it still says Anki Italic, whatever that's called, and it has a little diamond next to it because this is basically saying this is what the type family was, but it's not showing that way because I don't have that font on my machine. This one is also created with Anki Italic, but notice that it's not giving me any of the type tools, because essentially what I did was I took the font or the text box and I created outlines of the font. So then essentially it turned the letters into shapes. Now, this is hard because I can't come back in like I can here and change the word if I want to. So let's say I wanted to change this instead of type to typo. And I can't do that here because now these are just basic shapes. So that's a drawback of doing this. But if you're sending this to a printer, they just want to be able to have your design as exactly as the way you sent it to them. And they don't want to have to worry about trying to find the same font, and some of them won't even accept it if your type's not in outlines. So how do we actually create these outlines? Well, what you need to do is you need to click on the text box, go up to Object, or sorry, type, and click Create Outlines. And again, that's essentially going to convert your type to shapes. Now, I can take my direct selection tool and I can modify those shapes as needed, so that's a pretty cool feature. But again, I can't go back in here and edit this word if I needed to. Now, don't always assume that every machine has Times Roman, Arial, Georgia, Verdana, all those types of fonts, because there could be those random machines who don't have even the basics. So what you need to make sure is if you're going to send this to somebody for proofing or for printing or whatever, that you need to convert these to outlines. So again, I'll go to type, create outlines, and again, you can tell the difference between regular type and outlines because the outlines have anchor points just like a regular shape. So if I went back here to this paragraph, again, type, create outlines, but this again is hard because it turned them all into shapes, and I can't come here and edit this if I needed to. So in general, you should always keep a version of your project that doesn't have type created as outline so that you can edit it as needed, and then you would create a version that you would send to somebody else where it is all created in outlines.